Hey guys, Derek here from Pacific Coast Auto Japan, and we're taking a look at a Land Cruiser 70 series. This one here, the FRP top, or the removable hard top version of it. And so let's take a look at the vehicle condition compared to the auction sheet. This one's going to the USA. What's special about this one is it has been lifted and has 5-speed manual transmission and nice diesel engine, which is in fantastic condition. Okay, engine is great. It's a 3400cc 4-cylinder, and it's a diesel engine, a super reliable diesel engine, and for that reason it is noisy. And so for the remainder of the walk around, diesel engine gets turned off. That way you can actually hear what I'm saying. Okay, so the coolant and the oil both look to be in good shape. These 3400cc engines are ultra, ultra reliable. It says right here, BJ on the front. And BJ is the beginning of the chassis number for the Land Cruiser 70s. So there's the F, everyone knows the FJ Land Cruiser. FJ is gasoline, BJ means diesel, and so this one here is the diesel model. And before I get into the review, I just wanted to explain Land Cruisers to people who don't know them. They make kind of three different versions of the Land Cruiser, but two main ones that I want to talk about. There's the utilitarian version of the Land Cruiser, which the famous 40 series is. That's the old retro Land Cruiser that everybody loves. And then there's this one, the 70 series. Those are the utilitarian versions of them. They are tougher, more reliable, and better off-road, usually lighter, less sound deadening in them. And then there's the on-road versions, or the luxury or the comfort versions. And those are the 50 series, the 60 series, the 80 series, the 100 series, and the 200 series, and then whatever came after that, but I don't know because I don't really care about those ones. These utilitarian ones are the last forever version, and they only ever made two different versions of the utilitarian ones. This one came after this 40 series, started in 1984. They still make them today. I think up until 2015 they made them. And these are one of my all-time favorite vehicles because they'll last you forever. You should be able to get parts for the rest of your life, but parts don't break that often. It runs a really strong dual battery system. The engine's not fast, but it is dependable. Very big coolant system. You see the size of that radiator. And this one has been modified with an air intake, which probably doesn't do any good to this vehicle. Super duper horn system. That's aftermarket. And what else do we have in here? I'm not too sure. A big brake system. Master cylinder is nice and strong. And this one 5-speed with a hydraulic clutch. And yeah, this one is a 2-door version. You can also get them in 4-door with a longer wheelbase, and those ones are my absolute favorite Land Cruiser. This one, because it's shorter, will be more useful off-road, I guess. Okay, so let's look at the auction sheet, and then we'll do the once around of the vehicle. So let me just pull this guy down. I'm gonna do it inside the car because the windshield's too high because of cool lift on it. So what do we have here? This one is a 1984. Wow, first year of production, this one. Cool. Land Cruiser, 3400cc diesel. BJ73. 73 is the short wheelbase. 77 is the long wheelbase. And they make a couple of different ones, too. They make a pickup version and a long version with seats that are actually pointed toward the interior. Kind of the same like the Defender. Let me just show you how this is because it's the same. See, the seats are up on the side here. So there's a Land Cruiser with seats that come up on the side like this. Okay. Auction grade 3.5, interior C, and look at this, 251, 557 kilometers. Pay attention to that when we're looking at that, because for a Japanese vehicle, that's really, really high mileage. The condition of these vehicles holds up really well over time. Really, the only problem with Land Cruisers is rust, and this one has a little bit of it here and there, but compared to your average Land Cruiser, it's better condition, and I think that we got this one for a very good price. You can get them with a 4.2 liter diesel inline 6-cylinder. They cost more. I think both engines are good. The 4.2 is naturally aspirated in this, not the turbocharged one that is also available in the 80 series Land Cruiser. Pardon me if I'm making this confusing. It's original red, 5-speed manual air conditioning.
diesel, manual, FRP top, aftermarket steering wheel. Let me just give you a quick look at the FRP top. And so the whole white section there can come off. But if you're going to take that off, you really need to take these doors off too. And then there's a kit that gives you like a, this one, tailgate. Forgot my English for a second there. Not only does the top come off, but take a look, you have hinges on the windshield there, so you can flip your windshield down if you want to drive it with no windshield. And I haven't seen a lot of people do that, but you can find pictures of that on Google if you want. Google images. Okay, back at it. Let's see, Land Cruiser 70, they put that as a note on here because whoever owns a Land Cruiser 70 is automatically two levels cooler. What is this? Audio switch is something. I think they're referring to this. There's like a volume control for the audio there. Don't really know, but there is some aftermarket audio stuff. Sorry. I inconvenience that guy a lot, and he has a lot of patience for me. Sorry. This one here says, interior modifications are unknown on this car. Seat. Okay, this is what the auction report is. Seat ripped, and remember this for, because we're going to go over and show these details after. Interior dirty and scratched. Underside has surface rust, and one part has corrosion. I'm going to show you the part that I found with corrosion, and the only part I found, but keep in mind, without a lift, I can't find every single nook and cranny. This is the only place I found that has corrosion on it. You can see that it has been repaired there at one point, and the repair has cracked up. Also, aftermarket tubes here and front and rear bumpers. There's also a little bit of rust here. The auction sheet didn't mention this, but I mean, they did say undercar corrosion, which is something we recommend against for everyone except for our expert buyers. Land Cruisers are a little bit different in my mind. Corrosion on a Land Cruiser is just part of the package and should be taken care of. It's really up to the buyer what they want to do though. Left front tire house, dented, dashboard, peeling up. You can see it's right here. Okay, let's see, what's this? Footstep is his side sills or running boards. Aftermarket footstep, they called it. Bumper, suspension, air filter. And then there's C2, which is corrosion on the front here. There's a dent here, small dent here, and repainted panels on both sides here. Okay, so let's take a look at that. We're gonna have to lower the hood, and because it's a lifted truck, you get tire cam. Because I need two hands. Okay, so here's the coolness of it. Wait a second, I like to go around the other way. Notice the fender mirrors on it. This one came. Look at the bolts there. It came with door mirrors. Somebody swapped over to fender mirrors. They came original with both styles here in Japan. The fender mirrors kind of are cooler in my mind because not many vehicles came with fender mirrors. And it is really a Japanese thing. Up until like the early 90s, many cars came available with fender mirrors as an option because a lot of people would, you know, they started driving with the fender mirrors and they got used to it and then didn't want to change over. You can get an R32 Skyline with fender mirrors. Okay. So let's look at the C2 on the front bumper. This is aftermarket front bumper. Here it is. Really, really easy to fix that, especially since the front bumper is painted in a matte black and doesn't have to match the colors of anything else around it. So that's very nice. Here's the aftermarket side steps, nice and tucked up away so that you can do your off-road stuff. Rear bumper is small. And used to have some sort of winch thing attached there, as you can see. Suspension raised with shackles, as you can see here, probably a few inches. And then the tires on this one are 33, which I didn't realize that until I saw this truck, but probably the best size for tires on this are a 33, because 33 is almost as capable as you can get in terms of a tire. If you go up in tire size, you don't get a lot of capability extra, but a 33 on the back here fits perfectly with the doors. Take a look. You go to a 35, you will no longer be able to open your back doors. unless you get a different style of rack that allows you to pull the tire out. But the way that these Land Cruisers are, is it's attached directly onto the door there.
So 33s are perfect for these. And I guess that's good information to know if you did want to raise one of these trucks.
Close that. I guess I'll give you a quick view inside here.
Nice brown fabric. The short one doesn't have an awful lot of room compared to the long one, but it's decent. Plus that seat folds forward and then forward again to kind of flip-flop against the rear seats. It gives you plenty of room. You don't have to worry about ones that are flipped over to the side because you have all that room in there that you need.
Top seems to, it's got a rip up there, but otherwise it seems to be fine. Close the roof.
And the rest of the outside here. Okay, the wheel in the back doesn't match the ones that are on the car right now. Both are cool. The repaint looks like it was done fairly well. The car's wet. That's not a car. The truck is wet. I don't know if you would call this a truck or an SUV. This was before SUVs. 4x4 utility vehicle. And it uses solid axles front and rear, and that's a big thing when it comes to 4x4s, because the solid axle in the front is way more capable and way more dependable, because you don't really have drive shafts and control arms in the way to get bent up, and that kind of stuff is a lot more fragile than a nice solid beam axle like that. And everything looks to be in good and tidy shape up there.
Cool. Nice little hook here. That's extra cool points. And this model originally comes with a winch. If you take a look inside, there's a winch switch. It's a mechanical, runs off a drive shaft to the engine. And this one's been removed. The original bumper with the winch comes out a good deal. This one, they went to like a slim look, which I think looks great with it. Okay, hinge covers. And more hinge covers. So the hinges can be a place that rusts because it'll wipe off the paint. So having the hinge covers is a cool little extra.
Auto Pro Mechanic Shop, 178 motors, apparently.
Okay, so floor mats are missing.
It's a shame.
Nice brown interior. Seats are generally good. There is a cigarette burn in one of them. And here. There we go. This seat is generally good. Let me just rephrase it. There's the rip. It's been covered up with a fabric. Some sort of vinyl sheet. And then the long wheelbase comes with rear doors. The short wheelbase comes with a sneak your way in style. And then the rear bench seat. I've bought a few of them. This is the first one that is at a weird angle like this. I think it's just not sitting in there properly, but I haven't taken a look at it enough. Sitting in it in this angle is actually more comfortable than when the rear cushion is flat. It could just be that this one is an older one than the ones that we're used to purchasing, but I think it's really nice, especially because the cushion is not very wide, and so this angle makes it feel more comfortable sitting in it. You get a cigarette ashtray, I guess, and a little cubby spot,
and structure. Cool. And when you take off the top, you still get this beam here. It stays with you.
Yep. And slide windows, which I can't open one-handed. I'm not even going to try. Okay, let's get into the front. Doesn't smell bad inside. Land Cruisers are common vehicles to be smoked in here in Japan. I'm trying to move this. Can't do it with my head. And Van is coming. Sorry, Van. Run away. All right. Crank windows. Lots of fun. And pretty good condition door cards that match the seats.
Steering wheel's aftermarket Nardi unit.
That's pretty nice.
Okay, 251,000 kilometers. Starts really nicely. Watch this.
Okay, the AC works. Power steering feels a little bit lumpy, and so check that out. You get rear-wheel drive, four-wheel drive, or four-wheel drive low, and so four-wheel low allows you to climb mountains better. Here's the winch that has been removed, but you can still tell your friends that they have their own little thing to play with over there. This stuff's cool. And the head unit I removed, made out of metal, and stuff is inside there. Really cool. Love these trucks so much. Want one so badly, but it takes a long time to convince your wife, if your wife is my wife. She says, Land Cruisers look old. She wants, like, new cars and stuff. It's a shame. Land Cruisers are better than everything else, and everyone needs to own one. Yeah. That'll be the end of the video. Hope you enjoyed it, and leave a comment. And I like reading the comments. It's a lot of fun, even if you're making fun of me. That'll be the end of the video, and thanks for watching. Have a nice day.